Okay, so next we're going to create a user data type in the PLC just for some generic equipment that we will later use in our plant objects. So under my PLC, I'm going to go to PLC data types and I'll just click add new data type. So we're just going to create a generic UDT where each piece of equipment has a name, a state, which would be on or off, and a process value, which depending on the equipment, if it's a pump, it might be gallons per minute. If it's a motor, it might be RPM, stuff like that. For the first thing, I'll do name, and I will give that a data type of a wide string, and value, which is going to be our process value, and data type, I'm just going to do a unsigned integer, and then we'll do state, which will be a Boolean. And then we will go over and just rename this to equipment UDT. Okay, so we've got a UDT now, and under program blocks, we're going to add a new block. I'm just going to add a data block, and we're going to call it production lines. And just click OK. And we're going to create some instances of this equipment UDT for some conveyors and pumps and motors to represent different lines. I'm going to add a new one and just call this line one conveyor. And the data type is going to be equipment UDT. And so you can see it's got the member's name, value, and state. And then I'm going to create a line one motor. Same data type, and a line one pump, same data type. And I'm just going to repeat this for line two. Okay, so now we will update the PLC. So I'll right click and I'll just go to start simulation to get it running. And then we will load. And we'll just click load. And then we will choose to put it into the run mode when we're finished. And so the PLC should be updated. So now what we want to do is go into the HMI, create tags that point to our production line tags in DB1 and create our faceplates, and then we can create our plant objects. So we'll just minimize the PLC for right now and go into our runtime. And then under HMI tags, let's add a new tag table. Just call this PLC tags. And we'll add a new tag, and we're just going to call it line one conveyor. And we have to tell it what connection we're at, so we'll do HMI connection one. We will pick the little list icon here and go to production lines and pick line one conveyor and then pick none. So basically you're picking the top level here. And this will create basically a structure tag that has all the elements in it, name, state, and value. And then we're gonna add, of course, our line two conveyor. So we'll choose the list here, do our production lines, line two conveyor. None. And then we're going to repeat this with our motors and our pumps. So I just double clicked and it gave me the same name again. So we'll just call that line one motor. And again, make sure you click here so that you get this list icon, because if you go to the dot 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 icon and go to your line one motor, even if you choose none, then it doesn't work. And so what you have to do is choose this icon here, go to production lines, choose the top level, and then choose none, and then it's going to make the connection. So I'll double click, it's going to give me the same name, and I can just change motor to pump, click in this area here so that we get this icon, and then there's our line one pump, and I can go to none. And then we're going to do line two motor. There's my line two motor, click none, and then line two pump, get the list icon, and there's line two pump, none. Okay, so now we have our HMI tags. Now we're just going to create a couple of simple faceplates to use for our visualization. So we'll open our library, and I'm just going to add a new faceplate. So I'm going to double click, make sure you check unified, and I'll choose faceplate. So let's just call this conveyor. Make sure faceplate is chosen. Sometimes it'll change it on you if you change these radio buttons, and just click OK. So it's going to give you the work area. Now I've already got a conveyor graphic. And so if you don't have a graphic already for the equipment, then what you would need to do is go in and add a new graphic type. So for this conveyor, I can just drag and drop this guy in. And then we'll just put the picture up there. And so if you remember, we've got name, value, and state. So I'll move this down. I'm going to get that message out of the way. And we'll go to our toolbox. And I'll just take a text box and put it up here. And this is going to be the equipment name. And so if we make that a tag, then we can programmatically set that versus having to set it as a property. So that's kind of what I've chosen to do. So for the properties here, I'm just going to make that default to conveyor name. And then we're going to need an IO field for our process value. I'm just going to kind of size this or appropriately. We're going to need to set up actually our tag interface for these. So this is going to be our IO field. Maybe I'll make this a little bit bigger so it looks kind of okay. And then we're going to want to do a switch to turn it on and off. Text with pressed is going to be on. That'll be the on condition. And then just the regular text will be off. And then if you remember from our earlier lesson where we had our color pump, which looks like this, we had these two graphic images and we just had a Boolean that would either hide or show the green checkbox, and there's a red X under that. So we're gonna do the same thing back on our faceplate. So we've got equipment state on and equipment state off graphics. And so what I'll do is just kinda put these guys right here. And I'm going to right click and do arrange, bring to front on this guy. And I'm just going to leave it a little offset so you can see it behind. But let's get our size right on our faceplate. So let's say our width is about 225. And then our height, let's say about 275. That looks about right. And we need some properties. We need a state property, which will allow us to hide or show this graphic. We're going to need a value property that we can assign to the IO field. And then we need a name property that we can assign to this. So we'll go to our tag interface, and we're just going to create the same properties here. So there's name, and there's my W string, and then value, and we did an unsigned int on that. And then there's our state, of course, and I can just start typing and do Boolean here. We only want to show this if our state is 1. If it's 0, we don't want to show it. So we could come here and go to our properties and go to visibility, and then just set this to a tag. If I click this, it's only going to show whatever we've set up here. I kind of think of these as internal faceplate tags. But if we just set up to tag state, if it's true, then you're going to visible is going to be true, and you're going to see it. If it's false, and you're not, and you're going to see the X behind it. And then on our switch here, on the alternative state, we need to do a tag interface and also set this to our state tag. And then for our IO field, the process value is going to have a tag dynamization. And we're just going to add value to that. And then I'm just going to go up and make sure our foreground color, which is our font, is black. Background color is white. So that should work for us. And then for our label here, our dynamization for text, further we'll add a tag, and we are just going to set that to our name property. Once we're finished with it, then we're going to hit save project, and you can right click on here and just say release version, and that should get our version up to date. So now it's your turn. What I want you to do is Go back to visualization here, and I want you to create the equipment UDT and create your tags in DB1. And then create in the HMI tags that are assigned to those. And then go ahead and create a faceplate for the conveyor. And once you've done that, go ahead and create your motor and pump faceplates by duplicating your conveyor faceplate and just change your graphic and change your names. So go ahead and pause the video, complete the steps and catch up to where we're at. And then if you still need some help, I'll show you how I created the pump and motor faceplates. Okay, so hopefully you're all caught up now. And we're going to do our other two faceplates. So for the conveyor, I'm just going to right click, do duplicate type. Let's call it line pump. And then we're just going to right click and do edit type. Now it's going to look the same as conveyor, but notice that we've got line pump up here. So we'll get rid of this graphic. And then for this text, this is going to be our pump. So I'm just going to change this to pump name so that there's no confusion. I do have a graphic for a pump in here. If you don't, you can just go add new type and add a pump graphic of your choice. But I'll just pop this in here and I'll do a little bit of refactoring. I'm just going to kind of move this stuff down, make the pump graphic a little smaller, bring my IO field down, and I'll hit save there. And just looking at our tag interface, we got name, value, state. Looking at the visualization, of course, your O field, the process value is still set up to tag. Your switch alternative state is still set up to your state tag, as is the visibility is set up to state. Then, of course, the label up here is set up to your name. So we can just touch the icon here and release this version. Okay, so now that's ours. And then we can just do the same thing again. I'll just right click, duplicate the type. This is going to be our line motor. Click OK. And then we'll right click and do edit. So we do have the motor up here. I'll get rid of the conveyor and basically do the same steps that we did before. There's motor name. And I want to add my graphic. I'll just go ahead and move this stuff down. Here's a motor graphic. I'll just grab this and pop it up here and see what we look like. So there's our motor. And we'll save this. And everything should still be hooked up, obviously. I'm going to kind of center this guy here. And then I'll click this and do release the version. And click OK. So go ahead and finish those up. And then in the next section, we're going to create the actual plant objects and create our plant view and then show you how to use that in runtime. So here's your assignment 2. If you haven't kept up with the video, go ahead and create your PLC user data type with your DB and HMI tags and create faceplates for each equipment type shown in the video. And of course, you can refer back to the video anytime if you need help on specific steps.